Hey, welcome back, my friends. Today we go big. I mean, really very big, actually. Yeah, that's the painting that we're gonna do. And yeah, this is the material we're gonna use, as you can see. Set of brushes, linseed oil, and the set of colors here for the underpainting. And you see, I premixed the colors and start to apply them very thick, so that we have a very even and very nice layered color. See, I level out the color, trying to get away these brush strokes that we can see. And I blend the background very nice to enhance the effect of the distance we have in the painting. Then I mix another set of colors and actually use on two palettes the colors for the next layer, the underpainting, as you can see. Roughly getting in the shape that we need and the colors. It starts to look like a wave in a way, and yeah. And then let the whole thing dry for a couple of days and grab the next set of colors and yeah, start to work from the back to the front. And these colors here are very thinned down, and I start to build up those distant wave details in the back, as you can see. It's a very random process, very quick. Took me too long time, and I had to do some rework here and there. Had some more lighter tones in places. Do some blending, of course. Then we let this thing dry and start to mix the next set of colors for the wave in the background, more or less. What I do is basically I grab some color and dry brush, darken down a bit the existing color that is dry now. And here I'm building up the splashing part of the wave. As you can see, with a very ragged dagger brush. I'm using all kinds of brushes in this process here. And parts very, very thin, very very dry, the brush, as you can see here. There's hardly any color on. And I'm using this trick, or this way of applying the color, to get in a ton of details without a lot of effort. And those splashes need to be repeated also in the shadowy parts here, as you can see. Dots that can hardly be seen, but they are really vital for this part here. A bit further down the road, you see me putting on some detail, splashing parts here. And here I'm using another brush for those splashes that we have between the wave and the background. And here I'm using another brush, as you can see. It's a very hard brush here that allows me to really put in very quick, basically a ton of fine details. Again, I switch to the future more or less. Having here the part where I put on the details on this midsection here. And the key here is to, again, put in the details by adding the darker color on top of the lighter one, and the lighter color in places on top of the darker one, so that you, with a very minimal effect, with a very minimal effort, I'm basically able to trick the viewer's eye to have him see a lot of detail that are basically there, but just in parts of the painting. And that's what I do here now. And this is the center part of the painting here. And this one took me quite a long time. Where I basically dry brush over this dry surface here the details from the splashing wave that we have in front. And you see this greenish, yellowish color that I put on is basically the base color of the water. And this is, it's therefore very light and very greenish because the water, the light goes through more or less. Therefore, I have to repeatedly apply this greenish color here in places where we don't have any foam. This sounds a bit weird now, but the foam basically is blocking the sunlight. Therefore, I have already started to put in the foam on this middle part here. And the darkish bluish color is basically the foam that we have in the shadowy areas. This one blocks the sunlight from going through the water. And it may look a bit like blood vessels now at this stage, but it really is the way to paint a wave that we have light going through. And I basically repeat this process with a little bit of a trimmed down color on the midsection here of this part. So there we have a very translucent color, very translucent part of the water here. I'm basically readjusting the whole thing so that the water basically really looks very translucent. And then I start to build up the foam parts that we have here on top of the wave. And basically the same procedure. We have the darker bluish colors as the foam in the shadows, and the lighter whitish color as the color of the foam that is lit by the sunlight. And of course lots of variations with the greenish colors that we have here. Very fine details in places. I mean, this is a large painting, but I still try to do it very, very detailed, very, perhaps a bit too detailed. But I, for example, here, this is a very, I mean, you see, this is a huge painting, and I take a very small brush and add those really tiny marks. But I think those are vital in places to really have something really looking realistic and detailed. And so basically build up this foam part, those bluish colors in the background, or in those parts where the light is not going through, and very whitish color variation, whiter, bit darker, some green to it, some blue to it, and this really, it's basically just a bit like painting clouds, in a way. Giving the whole thing some volume. And this is, I think, the key to this part of the painting here. Letting it fade out on the left side. And adding some final details. Some very fine brush marks and dots here and there. And we're finished. If you'd like to see more about this topic, then make sure to check out one of these two videos here.